Okay, I'm going to take a look at the ear model, and one thing to point out first is that we're in the temporal bone with the middle and inner ear, so I'm removing some parts of the temporal bone. Let's see, the ear is divided into three sections. You have the outer ear, which includes the auricle, the external acoustic meatus, also called the ear canal, and the boundary for the outer ear is the eardrum, the tympanic membrane. Right here where I'm showing my pencil is the middle ear, and it contains these three bones, the malleus, the incus, and the stapes. And so the stapes is pushing into a structure called the oval window. So that's basically the boundary between the middle ear and the inner ear, because this structure here that I'm picking up, that's the inner ear. This is the middle ear with the boundary of the oval window and the eardrum or the tympanic membrane. And then you had the outer ear. So a sound wave will be directed inward by the auricle. It will travel down the external acoustic meatus. It will hit the tympanic membrane, which will push the malleus into the incus, into the stapes, which pushes in the oval window. And then now the sound signal has been delivered to the fluid of the inner ear. And over here, this snail-shaped cochlea is where hearing takes place. There's a structure in here called the organ of Corti. And the deal is the organ of Corti is in this membranous labyrinth. It's basically got hair cells in it, referred to as stereocilia and akinocilium. When the sound wave pushes into this partition of the inner ear, referred to as the cochlear duct, it will cause the floor of the cochlear duct to drop out and to sink. And when that happens, the hair cells will bend one way or the other. If the stereocilia bend toward the kinocilium, then we will have hearing take place. If the multiple stereocilia bend away from the single kinocilium, then we will be inhibiting hearing. So just keep in mind, hair cells in the organ of Corti, in the cochlear duct, in the cochlea, is how we receive the message about hearing. So cochlea, that's where the receptors are for hearing. And we continue to look at the inner ear. You see the semicircular canals. We have a lateral semicircular canal, an anterior one, and a posterior one. These have receptors that are going to detect dynamic equilibrium. So if I was going to become Wonder Woman by spinning in a circle, I would not get dizzy and fall down because these suckers are sending a message back about, hey, he's spinning in a circle. So dynamic equilibrium is being influenced by the semicircular canals. And then you have this thick part here of the inner ear referred to as the vestibule. It's got two receptors or two organs referred to as the utricle and the saccule. And those are going to monitor static equilibrium, back and forth and side to side movements of the head. So the parts of the inner ear, cochlea, the vestibule, the semicircular canals. This right here, the vestibule is static equilibrium. The semicircular canals are dynamic equilibrium. The cochlea is for hearing. Cochlear nerve, vestibular nerve, vestibulocochlear nerve. So cochlear, vestibular, vestibulocochlear. So that's cranial nerve 8. Here in the middle ear, you see the eustachian tube, which plays a role in equalizing the pressure so we don't have too much pressure in our ear to damage the tympanic membrane. This right here is the tensor veli palatini, a muscle that will raise our soft palate to make sure we don't get food up into our nasopharynx, but it also plays a role in regulating the diameter of the eustachian tube to play a role in the regulation of the pressure buildup in our middle ear. This right here is the tensor tympani. There's also another muscle that does the same thing as the tensor tympani called the stapedius. Well, those two muscles are going to be attached to the middle ear bones, and if a loud sound happens, they will make sure that we do not damage the hearing structures. Let's see. So what else to point out here? Just to kind of repeat a few things. The auricle directs me inward through the external acoustic meatus. I hit against the tympanic membrane. Now I'm in the middle ear. Malleus pushes incus, pushes stapes into the oval window. Now I'm in the inner ear, in the fluid of the cochlea. And then I'm going to pass into the cochlear duct. I will bend the hair cells, you know, bending the stereocilia towards the kinocilium, and hearing will take place. If I'm at a Pantera concert and I am headbanging, then that's going to be detected right here in the vestibule. Because remember, the utricle and the saccule are about static equilibrium, back and forth, side to side head movements. And then the semicircular canals, if I am going to twirl around in a circle, that's going to be detected here by the semicircular canals. And that's the basics of the ear model. Here is the internal carotid artery. I wanted to go ahead and point that out.